Checking whether or where a function is analytic or not is not so difficult. You can either use analyticity of some known functions, or you can look at the Cauchy-Riemann equations, as you will see in the examples in this video. So if you have, for example, f of z equals z squared plus 3 divided by z plus 1 times z squared plus 5, z equals a polynomial p of z divided by q of z. I suppose that f is defined on its maximal domain. Now, we know p of z is a polynomial, so it's analytic. Q of z is a product of polynomials, so q of z is analytic as well. Now, we know quotient of polynomials. A quotient of analytic functions is analytic. P and q are analytic, so our function f is analytic, unless you're dividing by zero, so f is analytic, unless q equals 0. So, where do we have q equals 0? Well, at z equals minus 1, or at z equals plus or minus the square root of 5 times I. So your f is analytic in all of c, except at the points minus 1 and plus or minus square root of 5 times I. So an example using Cauchy-Riemann equations. That's usually better if you have your f in terms of u and v, because then you can easily compute ux. So ux equals the cosine of x times the cosine hyperbolic of y. Uy equals the sine of x times the sine hyperbolic of y. Vx equals minus sine of x times the sine hyperbolic of y. And Vy differentiates with respect to y, we get cosine x times the cosine hyperbolic of y. So we check Cauchy-Riemann, the continuity. First of all, we observe that all the ux, etc., they are products of continuous functions, which means that they are continuous in all of R2. And then we see Cauchy-Riemann is satisfied because ux equals vy for all x and y, and uy equals minus vx for all x and y in R2, which means that the Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied for all x and y. So we see that f of z is analytic in all of C, which means that this f of z is an entire function.